Bonjour, how did we end up here? I don't really know. Anyway, we are in Paris. Mama show at East. And tomorrow, very last minute thing, I'm running the Paris half. I always have running stuff with me, so I'm semi-prepared. And ironically, the session that Coach Tommy gave me was a half marathon at race pace. Now, what I'm building up to officially, like, in my training is the London Marathon, April 21st, I think it is. And it's March 2nd right now. So that's what I'm officially going for. In the meantime, we've got this now. I've got LA Marathon, which I'll be pacing Mr. George Heaton on. And then the Speed Project, which will be crazy. But I think all of these events, by the way, are like the perfect lead up, because tomorrow I'm gonna rage. LA Marathon will be more like a tough long run, because I think George wants to go about a 3:20. So by no means, like, I'm not chilling, but it's within what I can do. And then Speed Project is 420 miles, but that's split between seven of us. So that works out 60 miles each. That is the end of March, like 28th. So that is 3 weekends before London. So March is now like the biggest training block. I think the Speed Project stuff will be amazing, because we'll be doing very short legs. So it'll be like speed work over a very long period. Obviously, I did it in Atacama in Chile, but getting prepped for this half right now. I think that training block, even though is not usual, I don't do things usually. I definitely don't fit the norm. So, and when I did my PB in Valencia, that was a week after the Speed Project. And I had to travel back from Chile. So I should be on course to run fast, basically. Making sure I drink a few matcha before bed. I've got my gels, more of the ones for me. I'll have a huel after, before I have some champagne or something. These are fresh out the box. Never worn them. A lot of the shoes I've worn for races, I've never worn before. This is the chaos that's in the room. There's some fashion week bits going on, so I bought those clothes. And also, straight from here, I'm going to Saudi Arabia, which is, I've got my greens. So I'll be crushing those. These are pretty fun, because if I'm gonna be out in the desert, I'm thinking I need some trail shoes. So I picked those up from Arc'teryx. Last night, I got so much sleep. Where's my phone? Let's check out Whoop. What is Whoop saying? Okay, here we go. Yeah, look at this shit. 10 hours and 4 minutes worth of sleep. It's actually in bed for 11 hours, but that's how much I was actually sleeping for. And that's up from an average, I think that means in the last 30 days, of 7 hours. Yeah, top class. HRV is at 142, I'm absolutely peaking. Sleep performance 100%, obviously. Calories today, I mean, I don't really look at that. I just do it off of how I feel. And measurements within range. Yep, blood oxygen, never really understand that one, but sure, it's great. Resting heart rate's down at 38, that's good. So yeah, prepared for the morning. I'm in the first group, other than the pros, obviously. Can't remember what time that means I start, but I guess, as I've been useless at filming stuff recently, who knows if this will make it towards anything other than something way, way, way in the future. But yeah, I'll wake up at 6, get over there. I didn't bring any warm clothes, as in like workout clothes. So we'll see how that goes tomorrow. It's gonna be 5 degrees. Anyway, see you later. Welcome back to another vlog. This is probably the only part of Paris you're gonna see, because I did fuck all when I was here. Whoops. I am going to AlUla in Saudi Arabia with Penhaligons, and it's gonna be mental. There's like balloon rides, there's Jeep driving in the desert. We're going to that big building in AlUla. You might have seen it. It's like a big mirrored building. It's the best way I can describe it, because that's exactly what it is. It looks like you're on Mars. It's gonna be absolutely fantastic. So yeah, I'm at Charles de Gaulle. I'm gonna check my shit in and remain excited. my Don is absolutely throwing it down on this piano. Wait.
Round of applause for that gentleman.
So this is me, Villa 62. Let's have a little look, shall we? This is some kind of dream, isn't it? Absolutely stunning. And here we go. Here is the reason we're all here. Penhaligons, the namesake, we're in AlUla. Beautiful. Here's the itinerary. Oh, very cute note.
We are doing a scented workshop, so don't know if I'm going to wait to smell it there or smell it here on my own and give feedback, but
this place is insane. I think the gym's just up there as well, so that's not too far away. Did a 10K run earlier. So yeah, my favourite thing to do when I get someone new is run anyway, unless I arrive at like midnight and then not such a good idea. But yeah, set me up nicely for the day. I feel less groggy. I need to check this place is actually real, because as far as I'm concerned right now, it's just like a movie set. And I know the Saudis have got some cash, so.
How mint is this?
Okay, these rocks are real. They're hurting my feet. Yeah, it feels pretty rocky. So, I'm gonna get some ab rolls in. Forward slash, I'm gonna go to the gym. I'll probably go gym first. Looked pretty good when we drove past it briefly earlier. Maybe sit on a bike, just do 10K. I don't know what I'm feeling like. Yeah, legit. All right, calm. Some bougie shit. Places any to do some playing. Such fun. This workout isn't interesting at all. These views are fucking mental.
It's got to be a balloon outfit, isn't it?
This screams, I do something in a plane or in the sky. In other news, this song, such a banger. It might be okay, might be cold, but I hate being cold, so I'm wearing this. Right, just man, waiting to get picked up.
This is your song, Mike, let's do it.
All right, here we go. One,
but yeah, hot two, air ballooning.
Three, and something.
Yeah, yeah.
A late for the safety briefing, guys. Let's make it hurry, please. Gentlemen will give you safety belt, and we are ready for a safety briefing.
Sorry.
So you can come.
I don't really sweat from my head, so you know it's hot when I do. Actually, I do when I'm inside for some reason.
on the absolute health train. Off at sunrise, well, before sunrise. I'm on a hot air balloon by sunrise, mate. Some 4:45 a.m. wake up. And what's the time now? I think it's about 11:30, 12. Came back, had some breakfast. What's the plan for the rest of the day? I think I'm on a hike. I think I got a hike at 3 p.m. And then, yeah, there's definitely some kind of dinner.
Raise your right leg and then flex it forward, back.
You're doing such a good timing in the shade, aren't you?
That's good for my head, because I'm feeling pretty red already.
Let's go.
Are you YouTubing, Will?
Yeah, just with the helmet.
I'm just going to say it again, those carbon footplates going to help you get up this mountain. And that.
Just.
I'd let the boss go, look at the speed.
So they describe this as medium to hard, which I guess makes sense. It does make sense though, it's not like...
It's medium for me, hard for you.
It's not like doing Runyon. Right. Oh yeah, how's it going now?
Oh, living. I know I got lungs, and I know I smoke with 10 years of them.
Testing them out. It's crazy. Oh, there's the little glow. There's a little building. Are we going to that at any point? Yeah, mate, it smells fucking pucker.
So the hike has been beautiful, it's been challenging. The guides have been amazing. When they say it's like medium hard, you assume, because you're on a trip, that it's not going to be that hard, but it has. We've been scrambling up stuff, hands and knees, but hard work really pays off when you've got a view like this. It's nothing, it's like nothing I've ever seen before. I'd say it's otherworldly, which...
Drop in.
Oh, solid.
That's a PCL gone.
No one got left behind, right?
No.
Sweet.
That was the last one.
How was that bit like going through for you?
Oh, I just went like this and down.
Yeah. It was hard though, wasn't it?
It was hard.
When I saw it, I was like,
yeah.
Are they serious?
I put my weight on the arms and yeah.
Kind of... Lovely.
Gold standard whey protein.
Of course.
Yeah.
That's
fine.
Wow, this is amazing.
Yeah. All right, we are ready.
Let's get some light, here we go.
These are my favourite trousers from Philippa K.
Ignore that shit.
So we've got, I showed you the dinner spot earlier. So obviously all going to be finished. And that thing was so beautiful, that big circular opening in the sky, and then we're looking at the stars. So just outside of that building, there's this this area where we're gonna lay down, look at the stars, and it'll probably be cold by then, so I'm gonna need a jumper. Woke up at 4:45, hot air balloon, breakfast, 9 mile run, didn't really eat lunch, hike, gym. I did 10k hard on the bike as well. And yeah, I've just been hydrating, so I'm really looking forward to eating something, but my words are... My new favourite mode of transport, absolutely zip around. Don't film and ride, Will, you fucking idiot.
Anyway, it's still going. Oh, that was...
was nearly disaster for everyone's entertainment, for fuck's sake. I can't remember the last time I was on one, to be honest.
Legit!
They're good?
Yeah! Still got it.
This is definitely in a trick.
Yeah, that would be so cool if they had some roof. Well, I mean, they have those coats for the evening.
Yeah.
Which are like the traditional desert coats.
Oh, fair play. 1-1.
Andy, what are we doing today?
We're on a Hegra tour today, the ancient city.
Sick. In Landes. In Landes.
In Landes. Off-roading, tombs, tours.
Sick. My only question is, can I drive at one point?
100%, mate. Do what you want.
Yes.
Oh, it's a shame they're cleaning it.
Yalla yalla.
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 Love it.
Love it.
What's the other one?
Wow.
Crazy.
Do we know what this one's called?
The grave with no body in it.
This is the most famous of the tombs. Don't know what it's called, sorry. I'll maybe get someone to write what it is here.
That's really nice.
But it's a singular rock. We obviously flew over this area yesterday in the hot air balloons.
So it's amazing to see it from the ground as well.
Is that going for it? Oh, guys.
Oh, I believe I am ready, sirs and madams.
Yeah, you ever seen someone in a fucking suit on one of these?
I don't know.
Yeehaw.
Right, let's wheel this shit up.
Good suit to the desert.
Yeah.
Wow.
And George as the shoe.
Gold.
Yeah, look
at that. Oh. How are you guys?
Good evening. How are you?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. How are you?
This one, the essence of AlUla, make local dill, local lemon, saffron, and touch of rose water.
Sounds beautiful. Thank you very much.
It's me.
Wow. This goes crazy. Good evening.
I'm
gonna get Komodo to my wedding.
They should produce my wedding.
Fucking hell.
Oh my god, I'm so mad at the quickfire.
It's me. Oh, the reflection is not so good. This is what we're working with.
We're live. Little salmon job. Doesn't look good under the light.
I should, probably shouldn't tell people that, but we're about to have a Heineken at 00.
Basically, I don't really have to be in LA until Tuesday, Wednesday. And the flight tomorrow is like real aggressive. I'd have to leave here at 4 a.m. So
why not fly direct to why not fly direct to Riyadh, see if I can watch the flight, and then the next morning see if I can fly to Jeddah for the F1. And you know, if you could pull something like that off on a fucking Thursday night at 11:15, you've only got one life, and if for some reason you're able to figure this shit out, fuck you guys about a number. If somehow you can figure it out, why not give it a crack? What do you mean? Yeah, obviously there's no seats available. Fuck you, I did all of this to get no seats. What do you tell me? Obviously there were going to be no seats. I thought this was a resale website.
Fucking Chaos. But, look, my training has been in, like, on point recently. And I don't want to leave early tomorrow because I want to get my run in. And go to Riyadh.
Right, this is getting booked.
All right, we're at the airport with about 25 minutes to take off. And Riyadh, I thought getting a hotel might be an issue. Absolutely not, mate. Crown Plaza, 100 quid. I think that's 20 minutes from the Kingdom Arena. Ramada, 116. Ramada, £80, 122. This
is going swimmingly well. This app I'm using is called Hotels Tonight, by the way. I have no affiliation whatsoever, but I think it gives you good deals on hotels tonight, you know what I'm saying? So
off we go again.
Joey Parker won, big up New Zealand. But this is entirely too late. I'm absolutely fried. It's up at 5:45 to run this morning. Flown here. It's now 3:15 in the morning. I think I could fall asleep during the fight. Thank you. Oh, and you can't drink, obviously, still. And the Cuba coffee's always too long.
David Hay and Conor Benson.
Anyway, Min, can't wait to go to bed. I booked my flight to Riyadh tomorrow.
Oh, that's Mr. David Hay again.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Second down.
Little traditional dress. It's so comfy. I think it looks well class. Yeah, yeah.
15 minutes, sweet, isn't it? Yeah, keep them clean, mate. Keep them fresh.
Red Bull first.
It's a little bit chaos, but it's obviously unbelievably cool.
But you can't say you can talk about.
Slow. Welcome to the paddocks. This one's actually well impressive. It's kind of like the first one I went to was Abu Dhabi, and it's obviously purpose built. And this looks sick. Honestly, all I want to do is get absolutely lit.
These mouthfuls, fucking health juices.
I have crushed them all, obviously, but it's not the point. But Dubai tomorrow, surprising Elliot, he's going to get well excited. And when he's well excited, all he wants to do is get drunk. So there's a positive there.
Absolute legend of a man. Skin's really good, isn't it? I might have to ask him what his routine is. Stays in? Well, you know who did the boxing yesterday?
Oh,
the rosewood. You! 905. This way. Look at it. Oh my god. Shit. That is fucking. It's like a movie.
Dubai's making too many clouds.
It's mad. Anyway, yeah, speaking of Dubai, we're here, little Charles. I arrived a little later than planned.
An impromptu 24 hours in Dubai.
Yes, but I was obviously coming for the long run Sunday, and now it's
Monday morning.
It's Monday morning.
7:40 a.m. on the way to concrete.
On the way to concrete, back to the business. I'm pretty knackered because my flight was at 11 p.m. I didn't sleep and I arrived here at 3.
You messaged me saying you were getting your running gear on outside the front door.
Yeah, well, I actually did try and call, but I was like, look, if I have to waste some time, I'll just go for a little 5k around the block. But he had just indeed woke up, so we went gym. And I'm just gonna surprise Elliot. I don't know how much energy I'm gonna have to surprise him. Like, yo, what's up, man? How are you doing here?
Can I use your room for 5 minutes and just go, man?
Yeah. Yeah, but yeah, we're here.
Yeah. Found him. Kite beach, sun's setting. He's extended the trip. Is it because of me? Probably not, but I'm actually going to the airport tomorrow. I'm on the airport, so it's going to be nice.
A little catch up.
A little 10k, 6 miler.
Right, Dubai, you've been great, but we are out. And the flight I'm taking is Eurowings. Never heard of it before. Saw it on Skyscanner. Saw that it wasn't bullshit. Business class, like 500 quid, one way to Berlin. Taking it, so I'm gonna see what it's like. I believe it's a fucking scam. Just means there's no one in the middle seat. This is not an overnight flight, otherwise I would be absolutely fucking fuming.